bunch of opponents in a row under 90 and give up 109 for the Rockets. What happens from one game to the next?
No, we're human, and I think sometimes you get a little slippage in the preparation of games. You come out a little flat, and a team is raring to go. You know, understanding that we got a victory against them last time we played at home, and they're going to be ready. And we came out a little too lax, and then when we make the effort, you know, sometimes it's a little bit too late.
I was just getting ready to call you.
Well, I wouldn't let you blame them. I would allow you to blame me before you can blame them.
Have you seen enough to know how the Pistons are different with AI?
Well, you understand they have a great scorer in Allen Iverson, and it's going to take some time for them to gel. They haven't been with one another too much time as far as getting that practice time in. It's a lot different when you're just playing games and things of that nature. So, understanding that if they get more practice time, they'll start to figure things out. They're in the NBA. They've been in the Eastern Conference Finals the past 5 years, so I'm sure they'll figure it out.
Has there been some readjustment with you guys getting Manu and Tony back, kind of remembering how to play with those guys?
Well, I think more or less for the new guys, it's a situation where they have to do that. But as far as the guys that have played with them, we understand the process. We understand where to be when they're doing their thing as far as penetrating to the basket. So with the younger guys or the new guys, it's a little more of an adjustment, and that's what film is for.
Have you ever missed a practice?
Yes.
And you just didn't want to go?
No, that's unacceptable. I'm a guy that I had a situation in college where a guy said, hey, the coach didn't say what time practice was tomorrow. I mean, we've had practice every day at 11 o'clock. So I just couldn't – it wouldn't sit well with me knowing that practice is at 11 and I don't show up. I'm talking about in college. So that's more of the human nature of me.
Texas Tech or Oklahoma?
Oh, man. I think Texas got the shaft. I think Texas got the shaft. But that's life, and they'll bounce back from it. But it's funny how a coach said, you know, we go into a big game against the number one team and we score over 40-something points. Then we go to another opponent's place where they haven't been beaten before and we run up so many points. I think that speaks for itself. I said, that's pretty good PR work that coach did. I'm not going to say what coach said it or did it, but it was pretty good. All right, fellas. Yeah, they are different. Chauncey was a big part of what they did and accomplished in the past, but now they got one heck of a player, a lot of talent, really hard to guard, and they turn them more unpredictable. So they really have a talented squad, and it's always been a tough matchup for us. Every time we play Detroit, it's tough, so we really want to get that loss against Houston back and take care of business at home. You know, it's very, very important for us.
When you take that heart and soul out of a team like that, how quickly can they replace that kind of factor?
Well, it does take a little time. Chance has been there for a long time, and now having a player that requires so much and is such a great player, being leading scorer in the NBA for years, so you need some time to adjust. But they are still as dangerous and as talented as before. So we know that, and we gotta be aware. We just gotta compete from the first minute till the 48.
You watching from the bench the first 12 games. Did you know what to expect from Roger and George when they?
Well, not from George. I really didn't know him. I heard good things coming from the coaches, but I never seen him play. He really surprised me. And the way he's taking care of business and how he's leading the team when he's in the court. So he's been great. About Roger, even though he's been 5 years in the league and we we played them many times. The fact that he was in Washington in the East, you don't get to play them as often. And I wasn't that sure that he was this kind of player that we are seeing him now. He's deadly when he gets inspired and starts letting those shots go. So both are, you know, being very important for us. And I think in the last game, we kind of, with the fact that Tony and me are back in the game, we kind of forget about them a little bit. So Tony and me, we got to realize that we were doing pretty good. They are great players, so we got to involve them more now we are back.
Does it take a while for that to happen, for you guys to all learn to play together and look for each other?
I guess it does. And in my case, at least, I can't speak for Tony, but the fact of, you know, being away from the court so long and then played 2-3 games, only 10 to 20 minutes, I wanted to do too much in small chunks of time. So I got to learn to be as patient as the first two games probably. Let the game come to me and don't force the issue as much. So I know I committed too many mistakes, and I'm going to try to learn from that.
How important is it going to be for Pop to find minutes for Roger and for George, even though you and Tony are back and they're going to be taking some of those minutes?
It's going to be tough because we are a pretty deep front court. Because not only them two, Tony and me, we got Finn, Bruce, and Ime. That all did, you know, Bruce, we know how important he is. Finn is a great shooter. Ime, every time he comes to the game, he contributes. So it's going to be tough for him, but that's why he's trying now. It's early in the season, and we got a lot of games to go.
Have you seen a difference in Matt Bonner on the court and maybe even in the locker room, the way he's played here in the last couple of weeks?
Oh, yeah, great turnaround. He didn't start the season well. He was hesitant, not taking shots that he should have taken. Pop was getting upset at him, and he didn't play for a couple of games. And I think that kind of turned his mentality a little bit. And now he's coming from the bench really aggressively, making tons of shots, playing hard. And that's what we want from him. That's what we expect from him. So we are very glad to see him bounce back the way he did in the last three games.
How are you feeling physically after this increase in minutes?
The back-to-back was a little tougher. Even though I maintained the 20-minute mark, I felt it a little bit in the second half. But as I always say, it's not an excuse. Just gotta keep working on it. When I'm tired, don't force the issue, as I said before, and let things happen. But I'm, of course, getting better. I mean, the first game against Memphis, I couldn't have played 20 minutes. So now I'm doing better, and hopefully this 2 days rest really helped me and to get my legs back and have a good game against Detroit.
How much of college football do you follow at all? Texas Tech, Oklahoma, any of it at all?
No, not at all. I just watch some highlights when the guys are watching, and I really admire those guys, the physicality and the strength and the ability they have, but I never watch full games, really.
See,
I don't follow it.
They all wear pads, so you don't, and, you know, they got an advantage.
I do wear some. They are hidden, though. They are hidden.